Hey, all right. Hello, welcome to the Visual Communication Talk. My name is Rich. If you have any questions, then please feel free to write them down in the chat. So I'm going to start off by talking about the award success of visual communication. So you can see here we've won 21 DNAD awards, 20 ISTD awards, one RSA award, one YCN, and one Creative Conscience. And this list continues to grow year on year. So we're very proud of our success, and we continue to champion our students throughout it. We also have quite a lot of success in terms of the press recently. So we've had students that were featured in 2017 on the Creative Review Grad Watch. So we had two students that were selected to be put into that article, ones to watch. And we've also had one of our senior lecturers, Sarah James. She was also picked up on Creative Block for her work in regards to working with students in regards to the theoretical component, and how we believe in visual communication that they should also use this as a design opportunity. So we believe that students should be considering the design aspect of everything that they produce, and this includes their theoretical unit as well. And that helps to get students to think about the communication of what they're producing in every instance of their output. So as you're probably aware, AUB has been awarded a gold rating in the Teaching Excellence Framework, and we're very proud of that aspect. So visual communication is very much focused in regards to the commercial industry, and you can see here that the statistics are very important in regards to the economy of the country, and we believe that's why we try to get this fine blend between the academic side of university but also the industry input from the agency sector. So we work very closely with the industry and the academic side to try and get this unique balance between those two components. We try to ensure that students have a commercial focus and try to encourage students to think about the commercial context in all of their briefs and work. So one of the projects that we start out with in the first year is a group project, and this group project is all about communicating in a space. So students are encouraged to get into groups of five and six, they have to pick a location within the campus, and then choose a word, and then use something called anamorphic typography to communicate that word in that space. So anamorphic typography is essentially all to do with perspective. So when you look at it from one perspective, you can read it as if it's being presented to you like flat on a piece of paper. But when you move around it in a 3D space, you can start to see the distortion and that it's not actually quite as it seems.
Walking across the floor, I love counting to the number four. Oh, you're counting with me to one less than five and one more than three. Whoa, oh, oh. We're counting to four. Whoa, oh, oh. Let's count some more. One, two, three, four penguins that were by the door. I love counting. counting to the number four. I see four here, I see four there. My favorite number, nothing can compare. Whoa, we're counting to four. Let's count some more. One, two, three, four. Chickens just back from the shore. I love counting, counting to the number four. Chickens just back from the shore. One, two, three, four. Penguins that were by the door. One, two, three, four. Monsters walking across the floor.
So we have a range of VTs or visiting lecturers and guest speakers come in, and they run workshops with our students. And this particular workshop was all about a photo montage illustration one-day workshop where students were using cutouts of newspaper and magazines to create a narrative that joins all these kind of monsters and creations and compiled them back together to make a short zine. And this was done again over a day, and a really, really exciting project for the students to work with, and again getting them to work with their hands and traditional media and mixing it with some kind of digital output. So again, talking about the kind of tradition and those sort of things, visual communication is very fortunate to have a good collection of letterpress and hot metal type and woodblock sort of letterpress, and this is fundamental for the students to understand about where certain traditions or terminology has come from. So we go through students and we very much encourage them to use aspects of the letterpress facilities, especially in their first year, to kind of experiment and understand some of the core principles, such as leading. So leading comes from the terminology of working with metal type. So it used to be literally bits of lead that sat in between the lines of type, and this terminology is still present in technology today. So the latest Adobe InDesign software refers to the line spacing as leading, and that's why, because it used to refer to this tradition of inserting lead in between. So we encourage students to explore the traditions and experiment with those, and then sort of consider how this sits in relation to today's sort of current practice. This is a good example in terms of looking at how visual communication is about exploring the hybridity of between the post-digital world and tradition. So, for instance, we were talking about the letterpress facilities, and we also have various other press facilities at AUB. And this is a project that we get students to do again in the first year, and we get them to create letter forms on the computer and create outlines from that. We then take them over to our 3D workshop, get the letter forms laser cut out of acrylic, and then the students then use these acrylic letter forms to create posters, typographic posters out of the composition. And there's some really lovely results, and it's really interesting to see that blend between new technology and tradition and where they kind of meet together to create this kind of interesting hybrid space. So we're also very interested in visual communication in regards to the entrepreneurship side. Students are encouraged to submit things to the Bristol Book Arts Fair and the Leeds Book Fairs. So we encourage students to kind of create things from a very early point in the course and to realise how that can then be used to create, work and potentially sales. So we encourage students to kind of think about the sort of the business side of their craft and their creative outputs. This is still another example of some of the work that was displayed. And again, we get very positive feedback from our stands. And the students get a huge sense of achievement of being able to see their work, put out there, and people taking an interest in it. So this is another project that we work with collaboratively with graphic design. So we were approached by Paul Borough Council, and they were looking at disused shops, so empty shops on the high street. So there was a temporary pop-up shop put up there, and we were given the opportunity to take it over for a week. So collaboration between the level 5 or second year students of visual communication and also the second year graphic design students, they came together. The students pitched several ideas, and then the idea that was chosen to go forward by a committee was this one, which was popped down, and the students then branded the shop and created various things in which to sell within the shop too. So a great experience for the students to consider about branding and but again that entrepreneurship of taking on a project like this and turning it into something quite tangible. So this is an example of a packaging project that one of our students has proposed. So she was looking at body rhythms, and she was very interested about how various sort of rhythms within the body would work. So she considered this. She looked at sort of digital responses in regards to the bottle and looking at the heart monitor. But she, in this screen, you can see that she's interested in the idea that the atomizer, when you squeezed it, would react to the heat and the touch. So again, sort of reflecting those kind of connections with the body and the blood cell. So again, some of these ideas are quite, perhaps they may be quite commercially questionable in terms of the fact that, this could be quite expensive, but the technology is there, and we encourage students to consider between the cutting edge of technology, and that was cutting edge at that time in regards to packaging, and seeing how these could be utilised within their discipline. So this is another project from a student who was interested in illustration. So she was very sort of touched by discovering the story of her father and how he was adopted, and she decided to express this narrative in a sort of a comic strip and book. So she took these the narrative of it and decided to illustrate this quite heartwarming story, really good, because it was a personal project. It was beautiful from that sense of point, but she also had this ability to explore a specialism that she was particularly interested in. And we try to create that space within visual communication. We try to enable students to who might be interested in, say, illustration or photography or design. And what we try to do is we take quite a broad range of students, and we teach them the fundamentals of type, image, and the idea of problem solving. We use those kind of sort of pillars to communicate messages, essentially. And then through that, what we try to do is, once we've got those sort of fundamentals developed, we try to encourage students to find their own interests and specialisms and pursue those with support from the academic staff. So this was a student, another student who was interested in illustration. She came to us, very set on being an illustrator. That's what she wanted to do. But as she went through the course, she discovered an interest and love for typography and hand-drawn typography in specifics. So she's now she went on from doing the course to do a placement within Dalton Marg, a successful type foundry, and she's now running workshops within her own practice in regards to this. This student, Fox Rogers, he came to us with a few drawings of birds, and was also very interested in illustration at that aspect. And he didn't have much more beyond a few drawings of birds. But our course leader, Sally, she interviewed him, and she could see a spark and a passion for his creative insights. And he flourished on the course. He's tremendously successful now, working in London, with various projects that I probably shouldn't be able to talk about here, but very, very successful. And this project was of particular interest to Fox, as he was his parents owned a laundrette, and he was very interested in the fact that laundrettes being one of these last remaining social spaces within the UK. So he decided to investigate the idea of and the notion of laundrettes, and he went around and he photographed them and collected stories, and he created this book that explored that social space. And again, the top left image is a really interesting kind of blend between the idea of inside a washing machine. You can see inside there, it's kind of like the drum, but that's kind of the example of how he was exploring the format of the book. So that's an example of something called a French fold, where the book is printed on the inside of the spreads as well as on the outside. So the idea that you could look inside, and it sort of reflected that notion of what's inside the washing machine. So this is an example of the ISTD Awards, so the International Society of Typographic Designers. So we have a good success rate in regards to our students who apply or enter into that that award. And last year we had 6 students who entered, and we got 6 students who passed. We had 3 students who had merit within that, so that's the a huge achievement, we continue to encourage students to explore that as part of their practice when they're in third year. So this student was interested in the relationship between the big issue sellers and the people who buy it. This was a monotype brief, and it was about creating a typeface. So the student had to look at creating a typeface for the big issue, which is a magazine to assist people who are homeless. So this student, really explored the subject matter, so much so that when he was down there and talking to people who were selling the big issue and observing them, he noticed that they tended to roll up the big issue and pass it on, much like a baton. And so the student took this idea decided that he'd create a typeface that could work on the edge of the paper. So when you rolled it up in the bottom right corner, you can see where it's rolled up, that the type comes together across all the various pages to be able to work and work as a typeface that way. And he used the ratio of the £2 coin, because the big issue was sold for around £2. And so he used the ratio of the diameter of the £2 coin to kind of work out that's how the fold on the typeface would work, and that's how the vendor would then pass it on. So again, that really nice relationship between that passing that relationship between the vendor and the buyer, being that baton that sort of strengthens that relationship. So it's not just they buy it and that's it, that's cold, but it's that kind of idea of looking at how people interact with each other. So he created a series of typefaces, and I think he's released this now, so I think you can either download it for free or buy it. So this is an example of how we encourage students to consider the design aspect of everything that they do. So this is an example of an essay that one of the third years has not only written but also designed and crafted at the end of it too. And that idea of craft is integral to the idea of visual communication. We're very much interested in how students craft their outcomes as well as just design them. So this is an example of a student who was looking at advertising. So this was a Ted Baker brief, and the idea with this brief was about trying to take what is a very English brand and taking it to other countries and how that would work. So this student was particularly interested in the idea of the cheeky British humour, so the seaside culture. So the idea with this is that, you'd have these billboards or posters around various outlets, and that when you came across them, you'd interact it with your mobile phone and you'd scan it. And as you waved your phone over it, it would create a sort of augmented reality of changing the image on your phone, where you might start to collect things. So in this instance, you can see that the model has lost his shoes, and you've picked them up in the right hand corner. And the idea again was that you'd go around and you'd collect these items, and when you collected them, you would be able to get discount on these items within the store. So a really interesting idea, and that idea of interacting with physical things and then transferring that across to a digital space. So interestingly, another sort of cheeky British humour used in a sort of an advertising sort of campaign. So this one was for the National Trust, and the idea was about how do you get students younger people, a younger audience interested in the National Trust. And the students came up with this angle that, the slightly cheeky, raunchy side of advertising could be used to put an alternative spin on some of these national treasures, if you like. They had a lot of fun with it. I won't go into too much details about some of the other ideas, probably best not to. So this student, he was very interested in hand-drawn typography too, he really wanted to create a series of prints. So for his final major project, he painstakingly drew all these illustrations, and then wanted to sort of consider about how these would be transformed into a physical output. And the way in which he ended up doing it was he created these, A3 polymer plates, which, you know, he exposed, got made up. And then this was then used to create these prints, which he then used to sell, which then funded the cost of the plate in the first instance. So the course supported that student in regards to getting the plate initially costed, and then the student contributed back to it through the output. So again, that's a really lovely sort of story of how it kind of teaches students to think about the entrepreneurial skills in the course. So this was a DNAD winner, so Design and Art Direction winner, a few years back. And this group of students were took on the Batiste, the dry shampoo brand. This was all about empowering women. And at this stage, this was at the kind of beginning of the trend of superheroes. So at this point, when this was out, superheroes were very much just sort of, starting to come out. There hadn't been the Avengers at that stage. I think there may have been, an Iron Man, that might have been it. But now we're at this point where, superheroes are everywhere. This was a really, really interesting proposal, and the idea of these kind of superheroes to empower women in this context. So this is another DNAD award success, also a second year group of students. So we get students to enter in the second year and in the third year for DNAD. And I'm pleased to say that last year this project was selected for a DNAD award and actually won a yellow pencil. So these two students went on and won their category within DNAD, so that was a huge success. So this student was really interested in sound and moving image, and for his final major project, he took the operatic by Philip Glass, Einstein on a Beach, and he decided to animate that and create visuals for that. Again, it's a really lovely moving image piece, which we have a link to on our presentation.
Holding hands in the moonlight. There was silence between them. So profound was their love for each other, they needed no words to express it. And so they sat in silence on a park bench with their bodies touching, holding hands in the moonlight. Finally, she spoke. "Do you love me, John?" she asked. "You know I love you, darling," he replied. "I love you more than tongue can tell. You are the light of my life, my sun, moon, and stars. You are my everything. Without you, I have no reason for being." Again, there was silence as the two lovers sat on a park bench, their bodies touching, holding hands in the moonlight. Once more she spoke. "How much do you love me, John?" she asked. He answered, "How much do I love you? Count the stars in the sky. Measure the waters of the oceans with a teaspoon. Number the grains of sand on the seashore." "Impossible, you say?"
But the student was so interested in the kind of the visuals and the way that it ran that he really got into sound engineering as well as the kind of animation side of it. And that became a really big interest for him. And, you know, this is an example of how students are kind of exposed to lots of different things initially, be it animation or print or letterpress or screen printing or something like that. And he decided to continue to pursue this in his third year project. He's now working for various TV companies, producing various online and TV content that is surrounding moving image. But another example of how students can work in a very tactile way, this student was very interested in the rhetoric of politicians. So he looked at the speeches made after a particular event in politics and looked and made a comparison between the Labour Party's movements and the Conservative Party's movements and mapped these over a period of time of two speeches and then combined these together. And if I go back to the previous slide, you can see that he used just the combination of pins or nails and twine in order to communicate this. And this is a really good example of how this is about communication. It's about communication of an idea, but it's beautifully visualized. And this is a kind of an installation piece was really, really successful. As part of a graduating year, we often go up to London for the Design and Art Direction New Blood Awards. This was one of our stands a year or two back. And I'm pleased to say that we were nominated for Best Stand at that stage. And that's really a huge success. So we very much champion our students wherever we can. And we believe the New Blood Awards is a really good opportunity in which to give our students the exposure that they deserve. And so this stand obviously attracted quite a bit of attention that year. So again, talking about DNAD success, so this is a lovely photo of Sally Hope, our course leader, with our students who were very successful that year. They won two yellow pencils each, so one for their design and category, and then the other one was for Students of the Year. So they kind of won these this double award, so really huge success. And you can see that our course leaders are very, very happy and extremely chuffed for our students. So very good. So at this stage, I think it's good to kind of talk about what a graduate's portfolio looks like. So I'll kind of briefly go through two graduate portfolios so you get an idea to see what students kind of end up sort of leaving with as a portfolio. So this student worked on the BBC suitcase brief, which is was a brief set by the BBC to look at how to engage people with their online content. So this was very much about how you could get that relationship to blur the lines between what's on, you know, online or what's on your TV, and looking at those kind of ideas. So the students came up with the concept of having something called the BBC suitcase. So the idea is that you would have one place that you'd collect all your content from the BBC, and then compile that, and you could take this wherever you went. So whether that was on tablet, whether it was on on a computer or on a TV. So that was that project.
The best thing about my suitcase is that I know it's personal to me. It's nice to know I can keep updated with all my favourite subjects and stories wherever I am. In the morning, I usually pack some news on my tablet and some radio on my phone to listen to throughout the day. BBC Suitcase isn't just for me, it's for everyone.
When I have a spare moment, I like to explore what the BBC has recommended for me. It's always exciting to browse through my favourite personalities to see what they keep in their suitcases. The BBC Suitcase is also great for my kids. It helps with their education, and I always find something entertaining to pack for later.
So this student was looking at something called the Insight Scheme. So he looked at branding this, which is something that we continue to trial out in the course, which is about blending the relationship between first years, second years, third years, and graduates and industry. So we continue to kind of try and explore that within the course. He was also very interested in his grandfather. So throughout the course, he did a project on an editorial project on his grandfather and looked at various photos and stories and compiled this together. So a lovely project that sort of was very heartwarming to him. This was an example of a project that he took on as a freelance, so for a commercial photographer. So he created an identity and a website. This was his ISTD, so the International Society of Typographic Designers. He entered this into the awards. And again, this is it's a huge project in which teaches students the fundamentals of setting large amounts of text. So it's a really good, useful project. project in which to explore. This was his laundrette project, Coming Clean. And this is the portfolio of another student of ours called Josh Ogden. Josh, had a really strong sense of eye for art direction. So he's really interested in art direction. And his final major project was looking at the Barbican, and in particular the footprint. So he took the footprint of the Barbican and devised a typeface, and then taking that typeface, he then looked to create it in 3D. So he used he cast one of the letter forms in concrete, this huge letter G, and then used this to create aspects of promotional material for the typeface. So you can see there the concrete G standing next to some of the collateral. This is where he was proposing it. So proposing the typeface being in back into the space. Josh was also very independent throughout the course. So he, alongside his studies, he also art directed a magazine called Justified. And he got that off his own back. He was running that. The course tried to support him where we could. And he's now up to the fifth or sixth edition of Justified. So he continues to put this out there into the domain. And some more examples of that. He was also guest art director for O'Cumley magazine. So again, alongside his studies, he looked at art directing for this magazine. And again, he's got a really strong sense of eye of art direction and the idea of type and image and how these two can work together to communicate. And again, he was part of the BBC Suitcase project, which I've just talked about. Okay, so this final example is a really interesting example of going back to that idea of looking at the blended space between sort of physical and digital interactions. And so this student, she was particularly interested in typography, but she was also interested in the interaction through various sort of movements. And in this instance, she proposed a dynamic typeface that would react with your heart rate. So you had a little heart rate monitor that you'd sort of strap to your finger, and as your heart rate increased, the type would react and respond to that and change due to the increase in speed or the decrease in speed. So the faster your heart rate beated, the sort of the larger the typeface would come. And this was very interesting project for the student, because not only did she propose the idea, but she also prototyped it. So within some of the workshops that I run, I look at something called an Arduino, which is a programmable chip. And the student used one of the workshops to kind of be inspired to then go on and teach herself some further bits of code. And she then investigated this and actually got this idea or concept into a working prototype. So, really, really successful project there. So I'm going to leave you with this quote, which is from Josh, who I showed you a portfolio. And this really goes on to summarize how the creative industry is kind of needing to be so flexible now, and that Viscom, provided him, the skills in which to be able to be flexible and respond to those things which hopefully, you know, is serving him well in industry at the moment. So I think that's it.